Hello friend, if you go to any Linux forum or subreddit, you will find countless debates where some users are promoting certain distros as the best for beginners, while others trying to dismiss them. So the question is, why some distributions are labeled beginner friendly while others are not? Why Ubuntu, Linux Mint, Manjaro or Zorin OS are labeled as beginner friendly distros while Arch and Gentoo are regarded as for pros? If you have found yourself caught in the middle of this discussion, don't worry, you are not alone. Therefore, today I would try to shed some light on this topic that has always sparked heated debates in the Linux community and clear up some common misconceptions regarding it as well. As of now, I have only posted about 10 videos on my channel, but believe me, I have already been blown away by the passion in the comment section. Some people praise one distro while others tear it down, and a few insist X distro is the best and everything else is garbage. But let's pause for a second. Why are we fighting over which distro is better? In reality, all these distributions are part of the same family. Under the hood, they are all GNU/Linux. What truly varies is the out-of-the-box experience, not the core system itself. What you can do in Linux Mint can also be done on Fedora. If Ubuntu has a particular look and feel, you can replicate the same in OpenSUSE. And while Arch comes as a rolling distro by default, you can make Debian do the same. So instead of getting caught up in this endless debate, let us take a step back and find out what does this beginner-friendly distro really mean. Are they genuinely better for new users, or is it just about how they are packaged? And finally, do they really even matter or not? Let's address this elephant in the room first. What does the term beginner-friendly distro even mean? In simple words, it means these distributions are designed with newcomers in mind, and they are tailored to mostly cater or attract beginners. But does that mean an advanced user cannot use these distros? Of course not. Anyone can use them. And there are plenty of examples available where advanced users are claiming that they use Ubuntu, and on the other hand, there are lots of users who started their Linux journey with Arch Linux back when they are beginners. Consequently, I believe that the numbers of criteria truly defining a Linux distribution as beginner friendly are quite limited. And among them, without a doubt, the first criteria is simplified installation. Distributions like Ubuntu, Linux Mint, the pioneers of so-called beginner-friendly distros, feature streamlined installer that guide you through the process step by step, making it easier to get started. You are not expected to know about disk partitioning, bootloaders, or command line tools. Compare this to Arch Linux or Gentoo. These distros assume you have a certain level of comfort with the command line interface and system configurations, therefore offering you more control rather than a guided installation process. But does it mean their installation process cannot be simplified? Absolutely not. With tools like Arch Install, installing Arch has become very straightforward even for beginners. Additionally, there are countless tutorials and videos on YouTube that demonstrate how to install Arch Linux using Calamaris installer. Then moving on to the second point, which is out-of-the-box experience. Linux distributions like Manjaro, Zorin OS or PopOS typically comes with pre-installed softwares and codecs, allowing you to start browsing the web, watching videos or create documents right away. These distros are designed to be easy to use for new users. On the other hand, advanced distros often provide a blank slate, giving you full control to customize and build your system exactly how you want. However, installing softwares and applications in these advanced distros is also very straightforward. You can easily access the built-in software center of the distribution and begin downloading the applications you need. The next point you can take is user interface. For example, just open the DistroWatch homepage and look at the top 3 popular distros, which are Linux Mint, MX Linux, and Endeavor OS. All of them comes out of the box with an easy to use desktop environment like Cinnamon, XFCE, or KDE Plasma, which feels familiar to users coming from Windows or macOS background. They are designed to be intuitive and easy to navigate. Comparing this to any advanced distro, they just do not offer you a default desktop environment, but they give you the option to choose anything you want. Finally, another major important thing is the community and support. Now, popular distros, which are often termed as beginner-friendly distros, come with a large active community and extensive documentation, making it easier for newcomers to find assistance. For instance, Ubuntu and Linux Mint forums are renowned for their depth and accessibility. But does that mean that advanced distros are lacking in community support? Not at all. Ask any seasoned Linux user, and regardless of the distro they use, they will likely have relied on Arch Wiki from time to time, which without a doubt is one of the best Linux documentation resource available on the web. So now if you ask me that does this debate over beginner-friendly distro even matter or not, then I would say the answer is both yes and no at the same time. Yes, it matters because, first and foremost, the distros which are specifically designed for new Linux users are incredibly helpful. They act as guides, leading these users by holding their hand through the exciting yet sometimes daunting world of Linux. Secondly, I truly believe that every distro has its place in the ecosystem. For me, it's like choosing between democracy and an authoritarian rule. No system is perfect, but having a choice makes all the difference. What works for one person might not work for someone else, and that's okay. No matter what they choose, it will still be better than what Microsoft and Apple has to offer. And I also think it does not matter because no matter what Linux distro you are choosing or using, fundamentally you are using a variation of GNU/Linux. They all share the same core, support same similar software, and uphold the same open source principle. While they may differ in kernel versions, desktop environments, and package managers, these differences can be largely circumvented. With sufficient effort, you can customize any Linux distribution to function and appear in a manner that suits your preferences. In reality, I think that fighting over which distro is better often scares away newcomers. Imagine being excited to try Linux only to see people arguing in the forum and comment sections about trivial issues. This creates unnecessary barriers for those who simply want to learn and explore. So it would be my humble request to the Linux community, please stop fighting about which distro is superior. Instead, let's focus on helping newcomers find their footing. Let's guide and support new users instead of gatekeeping. After all, we are all here because we love Linux. Instead of arguing, we should celebrate the diversity of the Linux ecosystem. It is this variety that makes Linux so powerful. There is something for everyone, whether you are a beginner or a seasoned professional. And my message to new Linux users will be, first of all, welcome to Linux. Don't let the debate scare you away. Remember, no matter which distro you choose, you are part of the same incredible community. Do not worry too much about finding the perfect Linux distribution. Start with any popular distro you like. Now, why should you start with a popular distro? Because if you stumble upon any issue, you will be able to find solutions very easily. And as you gain confidence, you can explore other distros and customize your experience. Remember, the journey is what makes Linux exciting. The thing you will learn on one distro will also work on another. So that's it. Tell me, what's your take on this? Have you ever felt overwhelmed by the distro wars? Share your thought in the comments below. And please subscribe to the channel if you have enjoyed this video and want more relatable content on free and open source topics. See you next time. Until then, happy open sourcing.